never got the flag.
So YouTube team, keep it clean. What's going on? It's Engraven here with another video. And over the past 24 hours, there has been a lot of speculation as to if the Ravens came to a contract extension with Lamar Jackson, or if they are very close to coming to one contract extension with Lamar Jackson. Reason being because of some very timely and cryptic tweets. And let's get right into it. Now, of course, we know Eric DaCosta let it be known months ago, like, hey, we're going to work on a contract extension with Lamar Jackson. We want him here for the foreseeable future. That is our guy. We know that, and we knew that. That was obvious. And we as Ravens fans, most of us, not everybody, but we as Ravens fans, most of us, we want Lamar Jackson here too, because it just makes sense. Like, did you not see what this guy did for the franchise? Like, we can go down the entire list, but we don't even need to. But Lamar Jackson gave life to the Baltimore Ravens again. He injected a new culture, a new vibe into the Ravens that they were clearly lacking. And we love Joe Flacco. This is nothing against Joe Flacco, but it was just time to move on. It was time to move on. And the Ravens, in your first time having a franchise quarterback, which was Joe Flacco, in your very next time where you go for another one and you strike, you got to keep him. You got to keep him. And I know there's been a lot of people say, oh, well, Lamar Jackson, he doesn't deserve this amount of money. Oh, Lamar Jackson, he doesn't deserve that amount of money. That dude, straight up, he deserves a blank check. He deserves a blank check, straight up. Because what Lamar Jackson does for the Baltimore Ravens, this is no plug-and-play offense. This is not an offense where you could take Lamar Jackson out, insert another quarterback in, and boom, oh, the Ravens are doing the same thing they did with Lamar Jackson. No. And you know that. But anyway, a lot of the speculation, it started yesterday, a little before 1:30, because the Ravens, they put out a tweet that was something from their podcast that featured Eric DaCosta, where he talked about a lot of different things. But this tweet, it was like a Lamar Jackson appreciation tweet. And I was wondering, like, okay. Now, we certainly appreciate Lamar Jackson, and we love when people actually put out positive messages about him, because, of course, you know, it's a lot of trolls out there and whatnot, and, you know, Ravens, every day I go on Twitter, man, from start to finish, from the first tweet that I see to the last tweet that I see, I will always see Ravens fans getting into it with somebody about Lamar Jackson. I'm like, oh my goodness, that takes a lot of energy, man, a lot of it, but I see it from morning till night. And I know y'all, anybody that's on Twitter, y'all have seen the same thing too. So, you know, Ravens fans, when it comes to Lamar Jackson, Ravens fans do not play. But anyway, so the Ravens, they put out this little excerpt from the podcast where Eric DaCosta, he talked about how Lamar Jackson, he's almost like a son. And it said he'd be the kind of guy you'd be very proud to have as a son. And Eric DaCosta, in that clip that the Ravens put out on their Twitter, he spoke highly about Lamar Jackson, one of the qualities about him, not even about his play, but about his leadership. And I'm like, okay, cool, a little bit random, but hey, we appreciate it, because that is something about Lamar Jackson that can, it doesn't go unnoticed. He is definitely a leader. And he brings people together. And I think he's one of those calm leaders. Because he's not out here giving all these pregame speeches. He's not out there yelling and this and that. But he leads by example. And he has created this unity with the team. And it's just been a beautiful thing to see. But that didn't really get people talking too much. Because I was like, okay, cool. Ravens, Eric DaCosta showing love to Lamar Jackson. He's showing that appreciation to Lamar. You'll be proud to have him as a son. Okay, cool. But then Lamar Jackson's response, well, he tagged the Ravens and he put SG and smart guys. And a lot of people were like, what does that mean? You know, Kodak Black with the whole sniper gang and whatnot. But what does that mean? He tagged the Ravens and put SG smart guys. Why would Lamar Jackson, this was about 5 hours after that appreciation post, but why would Lamar Jackson put that? I don't know. Interesting. So then he followed that up and put Eric DaCosta, EDC, every dollar counts. So it was funny because he quote tweeted the tweet that the Ravens put out with Eric DaCosta talking about him. And Eric DaCosta didn't mention money or anything like that. But then Lamar quote tweeted that and said, EDC, every dollar count. And it's funny because if y'all watched a recent episode of NFL Questions from subscribers, somebody called EDC.
Next question came from my boy Nick Britt. He said, I hope you like the draft as much as I did. In this pivotal offseason, I feel like I finally see the vision that EDC, aka every dollar counts, has for the team. I like that one. In a year where we could have went
now, I'm not
way.
Saying that Lamar, anybody watches the videos or whatnot, but I just felt like the timing was a little bit, it was a coincidence. Because somebody in question from subscribers called EDC that. They said EDC stands for every dollar counts. And I had never heard that before from anybody. But seeing Lamar say that, I said, oh, I don't know. But when he said that, it's like, okay, every dollar counts, huh? Every dollar counts. And you know the Ravens, of course, they signed Lamar Jackson up for his fifth-year extension. They picked up his fifth-year contract, his fifth-year option. So with that, so they got him for this year and next year. So he's under contract for the next 2 years. But that does not stop them from signing him to a contract extension. It really doesn't. Reason being because the contract extension, it wouldn't kick in until the year following the fifth-year option. Well, of course, he could have signing bonuses and stuff like that. But as far as it counting against the cap and all that stuff, it wouldn't really kick up until 2023. Yeah, because he signed through 2021 through 22, and 22 through 23 is the fifth-year option. So in 2023... that's when that contract would shoot up. I mean, and with the fifth-year option, it would shoot up to, what is it, 22, 23 mil? But with the contract extension, it wouldn't shoot up to the following year. So it makes it seem like, I don't know, man. I don't know. Is it us looking too deep into this thing? Because I know a lot of y'all felt the same way when y'all saw what was going on Twitter. And then Lamar Jackson, just the cherry on top last night. This guy was obviously on a private jet. He went on Instagram Live from a private jet. And where he was coming from, where he was going to, who knows? But you could almost think, like, you don't want to overthink this thing, but it is fun to sort of speculate about it. Could he have been on the way back to the castle to sign a contract extension? I don't know. We don't know, but it was just something fun to think about. So we'll, of course, see if this actually ends up being the case. Who knows? But we just got to be patient with it. And whether it is the case or not, it is definitely coming. Now, something else that this could possibly be, Lamar Jackson isn't the only one due for an extension. And they actually have somebody else on the team who is looking to get paid. And is in the final year of their deal. And they also said that they would be working on an extension with him too. And that's one Mark Andrews. So with Lamar Jackson, those cryptic tweets, they might not have even been about him. This could have been about them getting something done with Mark Andrews. So that's something also to keep in mind and to think about moving forward, because he's in the last year of his deal as well. So, anyway, team, keep it clean. I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. And we'll see if any of this speculation, if any of this stuff comes to fruition. I mean, we'll know it will eventually, but we'll see if it does sooner rather than later. I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. Team, keep it clean. We out.